Hello, welcome to session three of Shoe Tying Bootcamp. And today I just wanted to take a minute to tell you that you're doing such a good job. Calvin and I love showing you how to tie your shoes, and we wanted to give you a little bit of a different feel today for the session. Sometimes it gets really hard to do things that take a lot of new skills and frustrating moments. So, parents and caregivers, if you're feeling a little bit of pushback from your kiddos on being able to do this, or if it's too difficult, it's totally okay and it's totally normal. It just means that we back off a little bit and we take a different approach. So today, we're providing you with extra demonstrations on how to do the skill. And you can practice if you want to, but you don't have to. If you're watching how it's done and at least just reciting the steps in your head, then you're practicing, even if you're not doing it with your hands or with anything. So you're doing good. We want to know if you're making progress and if you're able to do this yet. So please tell us in the comments if you can tie your shoes yet. And if you're still having struggles, let us know too, because maybe we can come up with a new idea to help you. So let's for a second just close your eyes with me and sit crisscross applesauce. Go grab a pillow if you want to, but crisscross applesauce, okay?
Yeah, go ahead.
And I want you to close your eyes and use your imagination. And I want you to picture yourself with a big, giant sneaker. Maybe if you've been to L.L. Bean in Freeport, Maine, you can picture yourself with that big, giant boot and those big, giant laces. Can you picture that? Picture yourself with those giant laces making a big, huge X, going underneath and pulling tight and making a knot. Making a big, giant loop, making another big, giant loop. Putting those two loops into an X, going under and pulling tight again. Can you picture that in your head? Awesome. What does your sneaker look like? What does your boot look like? What color is it? Picture yourself tying that big, beautiful bow. Take a deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth, and repeat after me. I can tie my shoes.
Okay, here we go. We're gonna make an X. Go under. Pull tight. Make a loop, pinch.
Make a loop, pinch.
Make a loop, pinch, make an X, go under, and pull tight. We have a bow. And thank you to our assistant, Jace. Welcome back, Calvin, to Shoe Tying Bootcamp. He is my assistant today, holding up the shoe with shoelaces that he made. Okay, so we're going to make an X, go under, and pull tight. What's next? I forgot.
Make a loop.
Oh.
And pinch. Make a loop and pinch. Make an X, under, pull tight.
Under, and pull tight. What if I want to make a double knot? What would I do?
I'll do it. You would make an X, go under, pull tight.
Nice job. I love that one because the little fuzzy sticks are so soft. You do a little dabbing? Dance break! Did you want to show Jace what your actual shoe tying moves are?
What?
So what are the steps? You're gonna show Jace? Are you gonna tell him what they are?
It goes X, under, pull tight, make two loops, make an X just like at the beginning, make an X, go under, and then pull.
Don't forget to get outside as much as you possibly can. Get some nice fresh air in those lungs. And don't forget our rules. Remember them? Do you remember? Rule number one, it has to be fun. Rule number two, think beyond the shoe. Rule number three, repetition is the key. Rule number four, keep your session short. Repetition means lots and lots of practice, because that's really the only way that we can get good at something, is through lots and lots of practice. And keeping our session short means that we avoid a whole bunch of frustration and doing it too much so that we don't want to do it anymore. So maybe I will challenge you to use a stopwatch and see if how long you can practice, and then each day or each time that you practice, try to beat the time that you had before. So that's today's homework, is to just consume shoe tying practice however you choose, whether you're watching videos, whether you're making a cardboard shoe, or if you're tying your shoes. Okay? So use that stopwatch, see how long you can practice. And if you can tie your shoe, send me a video or a picture of it. I'd love to see it.
Move. Move, Mama.
Bye.